Hi, I'm Mike Graham with CHAUVET Professional. I'm here with Ben Dickman, one of our product managers, and today we're going to be talking about the Ovation E-910FC. So Ben, I see this is a color mixing lip slittle. Tell us a little more about it and what's different about this fixture.
Well, with the Ovation E-910, we decided to go a little bit different direction than any of our other color mixing fixtures. We're using 91 red, green, blue, amber, and lime LEDs to make the color mix.
So what's the great advantage of using lime LEDs?
Well, lime LEDs are really unique. They fit perfectly into that wavelength that the human eye sees the best. So what this does is it actually allows the fixture to appear brighter to the viewer, and it also falls into a sweet spot for color mixing, so it's a lot easier to color mix real subtle hues.
So what does it do to your CRI?
It actually helps the CRI quite a bit. We're up over 90 in most colors.
When you were developing this fixture, what markets did you have in mind?
Well, when we were developing this, we were really looking primarily at the performing arts, your theater, dance, and the like. But it's also a great fixture for the house of worship market, car shows, corporate events, anything of that kind.
I noticed we have a bunch of new lenses out here. Tell us what the differences are between these lenses and the lenses that we've previously released for the Ovation series.
Well, we went back to the drawing board on the optics with these. We redesigned it completely from the ground up because we weren't completely satisfied. We knew we could do better. And what we've come with is what I dare say probably one of the best lenses on the market. It's extremely flat and extremely sharp at projecting gobos.
I noticed that there's a lot of different markings on the bottoms of these lenses that we haven't had before. Can you tell us a little bit about those markings?
Yeah, when we go around and we ask people what they want to see in their fixtures, and when we're just looking around at different theaters and rental companies and the like, we notice that the first thing that every company does is they paint the ends of the lenses with a color code. So we thought, well, let's take that step out and make it easier for the customer. So we color coded our lenses so that each lens has its own color. But beyond that, we took it one step further and we also added some other visual markings. You'll notice the X on the 19, the hash on the 26, and the V on the 50. These are kind of a throwback to the old drafting symbols. So if you ever drew out a plot on paper before, you know those symbols very well.
With these new lenses, producing a field is so flat. Tell us about the gobo projection with these fixtures.
The gobo projection is amazing. It is extremely crisp from edge to edge. No more do you have it's focused in the middle and not on the outside or vice versa. It's flat across the entire range and it's tack sharp with no chromatic aberration.
So for example, if I'm using a steel gobo, do I have to still use a donut?
No, not at all. Even at close range, it's extremely sharp, even with the steel gobos.
So if I wanted to add in accessories like a gobo spin or glass gobos or something to that effect, will it still work?
Yeah, of course. Just like on our original E-190, we have an accessory slot in front of the gobo slot that'll fit any number of industry standard accessories. One thing you will notice though on our fixture is that the door that closes over the accessory slot is actually closed with thumb screws. You don't need a tool to open it. And it's also got a handy little tab on it so you can easily grab it and not be fumbling around in the dark.
I know one of the things that you did on this fixture was put a lot of work into the control functions. Can you tell us a little bit about what you did with that?
Yeah, we really did. When we were designing this fixture, kind of the mantra we had in our heads was no compromises. We didn't want the user to have to compromise anything to get the control functionality and get the output out of what they get for their money with the fixture. To that end, we've got control personalities from very, very simple, just 5-channel, you know, red, green, blue, amber, lime, all the way up to 15-channel, which includes 16-bit dimming for master and each individual color. And we also have a virtual color wheel and a virtual color temperature wheel, which are unique to our fixtures.
So can you tell us a little bit about the virtual color wheel? How does that work?
Sure. The virtual color wheel is a takeoff from our Ovation C640, our psych light that we released a couple years ago. We integrated popular Roscoe gel colors into this, and what we did is we actually sat in our lab here with a tungsten fixture and a gel sheet and matched exactly or as close as we possibly could those colors so that when you expect to see an R80, you get an R80 out of this fixture.
Now, for example, if somebody wants to dial in their own gel colors, how would they do that with this fixture?
Oh, it's very easy. We give you the recipes that we have. If you say, Ben, you're crazy, you're colorblind, your R80 is too green. Just go to our QRG or our user manual, and in there you'll see the recipe we use to create that color. So you can build your own palette, or you can take off from there.
Tell us about the virtual color temperature wheel. How does that work?
Well, we didn't want to neglect the television and studio market either. So with the addition of the lime LEDs, we found that we could make really beautiful whites and every color temperature of white from the very, very warm to the very, very cool. So what we did is we created a preset wheel, if you will, on a DMX channel, which again, we also give the recipes for in the user manual, that goes from 2800 Kelvin to 6500 Kelvin in increments of, you know, 500 degrees or so, and it also hits some of the sweet spots like 3200 and 5600. And also with that goes adjustable pulse width modulation, so that no matter what camera you're using, you can adjust the frequency of the LED so you don't get any flicker.
What about RDM control?
Well, RDM is something that we're integrating into just about every new fixture we've gotten. This one is no different. You've got full control over personality, address, and you can also monitor temperature and the like.
You mentioned that you've got control over each individual color as well as 16-bit operation. Can you explain what that means exactly?
Yeah, we thought that the user needed to be able to have full control over their fixture. We didn't want to say, well, you only really know how to color mix with red, green, and blue, so that's all you're going to get. We wanted to give you the ability to really mix. And so to that end, you've got your full control over red, green, blue, amber, and the lime LEDs. After a little bit of practice, it's going to become second nature using the lime, and most users are going to find it extremely useful when trying to mix subtle pastels and get some of those better whites out of the fixture.
Tell us about the display on this fixture. How does it work?
Well, we use an OLED display on this fixture, and what that means to the user is it's a full text readout. It's very easy to read, very crisp, very clear, and it allows us to use full text menus.
Tell us about the connection points. How easy is this fixture to integrate into your existing rig?
Well, it's very easy. We actually have 3- and 5-pin DMX connectors on the back of our units. It's kind of a standard that we go with Ovation, because not everybody has a 5-pin rig and not everybody has a 3-pin rig, so we want to make sure that everybody's taken care of there. We also use PowerCon in and through connections, so you can power link up to 6 units on one 20-amp circuit.
Ben, thanks a lot for taking a few minutes to walk us through this fixture. I'm sure it's going to be a hit.
It's been my pleasure, Mike.
For more information on this fixture or any other one of our fixtures, check us out on the web at chauvetprofessional.com. Thanks for watching. I'm Mike Graham. We'll catch you next time.